Tom Barrack, the former 2017 chair of the Trump Inaugural Fund, has been arrested and charged with acting as an unregistered foreign agent for work he did, according to the charges, lobbying Donald Trump on behalf of the United Arab Emirates. This is similar to what Rudy Giuliani, by the way, is being investigated for, but Giuliani is obviously was involved with Ukraine, not the UAE. So that's really the big difference here. But Tom Barrack, obviously an ally of Donald Trump, hell, worked, as I said, chaired the inaugural fund for Donald Trump, has been arrested, as have so many other of Donald Trump's allies over just the last few years. Remember when this guy was elected and he said only the best people, only the best people were going to be joining his administration, because he always only surrounds himself with the best people. Paul Manafort, Rick Gates, Steve Bannon, Michael Flynn, Michael Cohen, Roger Stone, George Papadopoulos, Elliott Broidy, Alan Weisselberg. Those are the names of every individual over the last 5 years that has been associated with Trump in one way or another, either working for his campaign, working for his administration, or working for him personally. Those are the people, and now we can add Tom Barrack to it, that have been arrested in the last 6 years. If you want to go to jail, I think at this point in the United States, one of the best way to make sure that happens is to go work for Donald Trump for a few months, because you can pretty much, based on the history here, pretty much assume you're going to end up in the slammer. And of course, let's not forget that Trump University, Trump Charitable Foundation, and of course the Trump Organization itself have also all been indicted. And again, Giuliani's still facing investigation, so it's likely he could be indicted. The lawyers filing lawsuits, election challenge lawsuits on behalf of Donald Trump, they're all getting hit with billion-dollar defamation suits. Everybody who has associated themselves with Donald Trump has watched their life get flushed down the toilet, with the exception, I guess, of Steve Bannon and Roger Stone. They both got presidential pardons, so they're back out there, you know, doing their thing. But you can't help but wonder why Trump associates with so many criminals, right? Isn't that a little suspicious? You know, if you found out that your neighbor, that, you know, 12 people he knows over the last 5 years have gone to jail, wouldn't you start scratching your chin a little bit and be like, well, hold up now, John. Why do all your friends go to jail? I don't know, man. Bad luck, I guess, right? No, it's because John is probably doing illegal stuff too in that scenario. You don't just randomly find a dozen people that come and go from your life that all end up being criminals. That's just not something that happens. The odds of that are absolutely astronomical. But if you yourself are doing things that aren't quite on the level, then yes, it would make sense for most of your associates to end up arrested or charged or, hell, at least investigated. And that's what we're seeing with Donald Trump. The more that the people around him go down, the more it makes it look like this guy has obviously got some skeletons in his closet too that hopefully investigators are eventually going to flush out. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like, comment, share, and most importantly, subscribe to our channel for fresh content 7 days a week.